Hi all, hope all are fine as well as great. I'm Lakshmi. I'm working as a management faculty at International Center, Indira Gandhi Open University. This is my first video. In this video, we are going to discuss the important questions of Unit 1 of PCOE 108, the Company Law paper. Here, we will discuss each questions along with their answers in a detailed manner. So I hope it will be helpful for many of you while preparing for your examination. Let's get into the video. So these are some of the important questions that have taken from the previous year question papers. So the questions include, what do you mean by lifting of corporate veil? What do you mean by company? What's an illegal association? What do you mean by one man company? What is the difference between company and partnership? What are the different types of companies? So let's discuss these questions in a detailed manner along with their answers in the upcoming slides. So the first question is, explain the meaning of lifting of corporate veil. Discuss any four circumstances when the corporate veil can be lifted. It's a 10-mark question. So while answering this question, you have to answer what you mean by corporate veil, what do you mean by the lifting of corporate veil, and what are the circumstances under which the corporate veil can be lifted. So first we will discuss what you mean by corporate veil. As we all know, companies are regarded as a separate legal entity. So it is different from the promoters, shareholders and directors. So separating the company from the promoters, that is the concept of corporate veil. So the promoters are getting a protection and they are distinct from the company. So this protection is applicable only if the company is doing the business in the honest manner. If any fraudulent activity happens, it can lead to the lifting of the corporate veil, and that process is known as lifting or piercing through the corporate veil. There are certain circumstances under which the corporate veil can be lifted. So that can be categorized into two headings. First is judicial interpretation and the second one is statutory provision. In the next slide, we will discuss more about the judicial interpretation as well as the statutory provision. So the first one is judicial interpretation. So judicial interpretation means through the judicial decision, the corporate veil of a company can be lifted. So there are certain cases in which this judicial interpretation happens and the corporate veil can be lifted. In your textbook, around 10 to 11 cases are described. Here I am discussing only four cases. So the first case is where the company is used for some illegal or improper purpose. So the running of a company is for some improper purpose or some illegal activity. Then the corporate veil can be lifted. Second case is that where the company is a mere sham or cloak. They formed the company, they registered the company, but the aim of running the company is to do some fraud activity. So in that case also, corporate veil can be lifted. The third condition is avoidance of welfare measures. If the company fails to provide the welfare measures to its employees, the court can intervene. Then, in case of economic offenses, the company was convicted of any economic offenses, the court can lift the veil. Second one is statutory provision. Statutory provision means, as per the Company Act of 2013, there are certain circumstances in which the directors or members of the company may be held primarily liable. So, first one is misstatement in the prospectus. If there is any misstatement in the prospectus, as per the section 34 and 35 of Company Act, it is a punishable offense, and the person attempts to furnish the false or untrue statement in the prospectus will be fined. Along with that, he has to face the imprisonment also. The second case is failure to return application money. So under section 39(3) of the Company Act, against allotment of securities, if the minimum amount of subscription has not been received, then the application money should be returned to the concerned person. If a company failed to do so, that is company failed to return the application money, then it is also a offense, and then by statutory provision, the company's corporate veil can be lifted. In that case also, the officers in default will be fined. So these are the two conditions under which the corporate veil can be lifted. First is judicial interpretation and the second one is statutory provision. Okay, let's move to the second. What is a company? Explain its main features. So as per the section 220 of the Company Act of 2013, a company means a company that is incorporated under this act, that is the Company Act of 2013, or under any previous company law act. Another definition by Professor Haney, that is, a company is an artificial person. It is created by the law and it has a separate legal entity with perpetual succession and common seal. Now just we will discuss what are the features of a company. So the first feature is artificial person. A company is an artificial person that is created by the law. It implies that it has all the legal rights in matters of conducting the business like a real person. Second feature is it's a separate legal entity. So when a company is said to be a separate legal entity, it can hold the property in its name, it can enter into an agreement with others, it can sue others, and it can be sued by others. So if some disagreement happened, the company can sue against the other person, and the other person has some disagreement with the company, he can also file a suit against the company. The third point is creation of law. It is a creation of law, that is, company means an association of two or more persons. That is not applicable in the case of a one person company. As per the current Company Act, that is the Company Act of 2013, one person company is a legal entity. In the case of public company, 7 persons should be there. In the case of a private company, 2 persons should be there to form a company. So it is a creation of law. Next feature is liability, that is limited liability. So the liability of a shareholders of a limited company is limited to the value of shares subscribed to or to the amount of guarantee given by them. The fifth property is a common seal. That means the company, being an artificial person, it cannot sign for itself. So therefore the law provides a use of common seal as a substitute for the signature. Okay, so that is the fifth feature. The sixth feature is transferability of shares. Shares of a public company can be freely transferable, but that is not possible in the case of a private. The seventh feature is perpetual succession. That is, a company enjoys continuous or uninterrupted existence and its life is not affected by the death, insolvency, lunacy, etc. of its members. If the death happened, then insolvency happened to any of the members or directors of the company, it will not have any impact on the existence of the company. Company will continue to exist until unless its winding up happens. So it's a creation of law. So the winding up also a legal process. Then the eighth property is separate property. So that is, the shareholders are the true owners of the company. Okay, but they are not, it's neither possible for them to interfere in the day-to-day management of the company. So they appointed a group of directors and they are known as BOD, and they are elected by the shareholders. They are looking the day-to-day activities of a company. Then the last feature is company may sue and be sued in its own name. That is, a company can enter into contract and it can enforce the contractual rights against others and it can be sued by others. Okay, so the next question, that is, if death of a member or death of all members of a company happen, will the company exist? If so, give reason. Definitely, just now only we discussed, that is, the company will continue to exist. It will not have an impact by the death or insolvency or lunacy of any of its members. So that feature is the perpetual succession. That is, the company will continue to exist. The fourth question is, what is an illegal association? What are its consequences? So according to section 464 of a Company Act of 2013, any company or association of persons or partnership in which the number of members is more than 50. So the number of members associated is more than 50. They are carrying the business for a profit, but they are not registered the company under any act. So then it will come under an illegal association. So three things you have to remember. It is an association of more than 50 members. It is running the business for making the profit, but it is not registered under the Company Act. So then these three things are prevailing, then it is coming under an illegal association. The consequences. What are the consequences of making an illegal association? So the first consequence is no right to sue. Since it is not a legal entity, it has no right to sue. Second one, not able to enter into contract. We all also know that when a company wants to enter into contract, it should be a legal entity. Since the illegal association is not a legal entity, it cannot enter into a contract. It has unlimited liability. Then the fourth consequence is no winding up. As per the law, it is not existing, so there is no question of winding up. Then dissolution. So dissolution is also not possible because there is nothing to dissolve due to its non-existent. Subsequent reduction. So the company is company wants to, that is the legal association wants to make it a legal one. So for that, they reduce the number, that is number of members, to less than 50. Then also it is not possible. If they wants to make it an illegal, so make an illegal association to a legally valid one, they have to reduce the number. Along with that, it has to register the association under Company Act. Then the remedy. Since the investors or the contributors know the fact that they have contributed to an illegal association, so there will not be any remedy available for its members to their contribution. So that's the end of this video. In the next video, we will discuss the remaining questions along with their answers. Okay, I hope this section will be helpful for you. If you like the video, please share it and subscribe it. And then for more videos and notification, please like, share and subscribe. And if you have any queries or suggestions regarding the contents, please mention these in the comment section. So in the upcoming sections, we are planning to include more papers of MCOM, MPA, BTS, etc. So study well for your examination. Stay safe, stay healthy. All the best for examination. Thank you.